We'll wait for 15 minutes or 10 minutes for the people to join and then we can start.
Okay. Okay, Sukru. Right.
Thank you.
We'll wait.
Thank you. son Vihan, he's good at studies. But one thing that he always struggled.
We can start with the webinar and let the participants or the participants join in. So a very good afternoon to everyone. I welcome you all to this 18th webinar of the knowledge series of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, organized by Agriculture Skill Council of India. As we all are aware that farm mechanization has come to a long way, the issues pertaining to farm productivity are now largely tackled through the use of farm equipment and tractors. The employment of mechanized parts in the field has been a pioneer for the changes in agriculture sector. The Indian agriculture tractor market is about to witness a CAGR of about 4.5%. Now to understand the scope and overview of the tractor industry, I welcome our esteemed speakers from Escorts Private Limited. Let me introduce Mr. Anand and Mr. Umesh. Mr. Umesh M. is Senior Engineer, Senior Manager, Technical Training from Escorts Training Private Limited. He has over 17 years of experience in sales and marketing, as well as training functions with market players like.
Sukruti, you're on
mute. You're on mute,
Sukruti. Just a moment, yes, yes. He has over 17 years of experience with TVS & Sons Limited, Mahindra & Mahindra Limited. Accompanying him is Mr. Anand, who is a certified instructional designer and have over 17 years of experience in training and functions, sales and marketing functions. So over to you, Mr. Umesh. I would request everyone to put their queries in the chat box and we can have a Q&A session at the end.
Yeah, thank you, Sukruti. Good afternoon all. It's pleased to have this meeting in ASA platform. So, it's warm welcome to this scope and overview of the tractor industry, right? So can you move to the next? So this is what today's session, we're going to brief of this scope and overview of Indian tractor industry, right? So before starting this, so since it is the afternoon session, so I would like to check your present activeness, right? So before pitching into this area, so let's brief me agenda on this. So can you move to next slide, agenda? Yes. So this is what our today's agenda. So one is the familiarization of the tractor industry, then past and current market scenarios, factors affecting the tractor industry, and analyze and interferences of the tractor market. So based on the zone as per category and state wise, tractor market potential, and apart from that, so we're going to discuss on this other machineries and mechanization. So these are the topics we're going to discuss in today's session. So before entering to the topic, right? So let me have one poll. So I want to check your activeness in the program. So I would like request to.
The poll is active for the audience.
Yeah. So the poll is on now.
The question is.
Yeah. India is the dash market for tractors with about dash contribution in world's tractor industry's value.
So far we got 5 responses, whereas we have 30 plus participants. Yeah, great. We started getting the responses.
Okay, we have total strength of more than 30, right? Yeah.
Yes, Sumesh.
So let's others to do quickly.
Yeah, yeah, we're getting the numbers now.
Okay, what about this? So let's close it in 10 seconds.
22 responses so far.
Okay, let's close the poll. Yeah. All right, so the poll result, so we shall share that. Yeah, so this is the poll result you can see now. So maximum people, more than 60% people chosen this largest, and 27%. Yes, great. The second one is at 20%, and yeah, we'll see other options as well. Okay. All right. So thank you.
Which is the correct answer, Umesh?
So let's see on the next slide.
Okay, great.
So our participants are too active, and they have chosen the right answer, I hope. Yeah. Yes. So as you chosen, your answer is right. So those who chosen the answer, yes, India is the biggest market for tractors, and it's contributing at 1/3 of the total industry's volume in the world market. Yes, as you can see in the table, so TAV in the year, it is 2017. So we're taking the example. The total TAV is 2.2 million tractors. So in this worldwide figures also we can see. So the top yellow color mentioned, so this is the developed countries like USA, Canada, Europe, Japan, and Korea. So it's having a tier four norms. They're having stringent emission norms. If we want to export our machines to these countries, the emission norms should be met. And other developing countries like Latin America, Africa, India, Australia, New Zealand, and the East area, Southeast Asia. So this is having a little bit lower emission norms, so that the same tractors we're producing in our country, so with meeting with some safety norms, we can export comfortably to these countries, right? So this is what figure says. As you can see, the figures and other important markets are China, Europe, and USA. So the world largest tractor producer and as well as exporter and is India. So we can see the figures. So China is contributing around 5 lakh, and Europe and Turkey put together more than 2 lakh. So where India is contributing more than 6 lakh in the year 2017, but it is crossed now more than 9 lakh figures. Yeah. So as you can see the industry trends. So in 1950s and 60s time, so there were very few machines were there. So the numbers you can see only 8,000, and in 1960s period 31,000. So these machines, the demand met through importing the tractors after Second World War. At the same time, so you can see in 2000, so put together total volumes in 5 decades. So 2.5 million tractors, the volumes. Another 20 lakhs tractors added. So after 2000 in 20 years of span time. Yeah, so if you talk about other, apart from the tractors, also other machines like power tillers, combines, and stationary powers. So we can see the numbers are increased. So it means that the mechanization is keep on increasing. If you talk about the growth rate, it is low. After India got independence from the British, so in the 1947, so the level of agricultural mechanization was very low. So then this, based on the government promotion, the mechanization 1950s and 60s time, the 5 years plan aggressively. So they started this manufacturing of the tractors in that period. So, but the, if you talk about the tractors rate, the rate of production and market in the 3 decades, so very slow growth. In 1980s, the total tractors produced in our country is the volumes. There are total 1,40,000 units. So this was the figures. And if we talk about the distribution rate, so it was less than 2 units per 1,000 farmers. So this was the production year in that, the figures. In 1999, say this Food and Agriculture Organization estimated the less than 50% is under mechanized. So it's indicating that there are huge opportunities in the mechanization area. In early 2000, yes, so India produced higher number of machines and it overtook the United States. So it's became world largest tractor producer. And if you talk about that today's figure in the last year, 2021, we produced 980,000 tractors. And so at the same time, we exported 10% of the total volumes to the different parts of the country. So close to approximately 9 lakh tractors we sold in domestic market. So at present, if you talk about Indian market manufacturers, there are total 18 domestic and 4 multinational companies are existing in our country. Let's have a trend line. So here in 1950 to 1960, there were no manufacturers. So the tractors were imported like so Soviet Union, and after Second World War, the surplus tractors, bulldozers, okay. So by importing these machines, we are meeting our demand in that period. In 1960 and 1980, so in this period, so because of the demand, local industries tie up, and the international market, technical collaboration made with the other companies, the Indian industries started producing of the tractors, like companies like Escorts, Eicher, HMT, Massey Ferguson, and Mahindra Mahindra. So these were the existing players. So in 1980 to 1990, so there were no entry of the other manufacturers. So only these players produced the tractors. So reached 12 lakhs so by 1990 period time. And at the same time in 1991 to 2000, so economic reformation happened, and at the same time the de-license happened. So in 1960s we made the technical collaboration, but where we cannot change the design factors in the machines without taking the approval from the that outside nations. So that was the situation when this economic reforms takes place, de-licensing happened, so that based on our customer demand, we can able to change the design. At the same time, there are other manufacturers entered in the market like John Deere, New Holland, SAMI Dietzberg and Sonalika International. So at the end of 2000, there was total 23 lakhs of total value. Yeah. In 2000 to 2020, so the population reached about 50 lakhs. And at the same time, so because of the changes, because of the technologies, there are more competitiveness in the market at present. Next. So let us talk about this. What are the factors affecting the tractor market and driving the tractors? So these are a few factors we figure out here. So the one is labor issue warrant increase for mechanization is the one point. And second one is the increased agriculture productivity on higher mechanization and rising alternate usage and rental model, effect of monsoon on tractor industry. So adequate reservoir level. So next, the government policy. Yes, this is also one of the major point. And demand of food grains. So our vision. Let's talk one by one. So in this table, you can see in year 1991, the country's population was 846 million. Total number of workers in that 313 million. Workers percentage, if we talk about 37. At the same time, number of agriculture workers. So there are 185 million. These put together numbers of cultivators and laborers. If we talk about the percentage of the total population, involved in the agriculture, so there were 59%. Yes, at the same time, if you talk about in 2020, so the population increased, yes, this 1,323 million, and the workforce, if you talk about, there are 566, it is increased, and at the same time, the percentage of the workforce also increased, 42%. Number of agri workers, so you can see here, so 230 million, so contributing here 40%. Where 1990s involved 59% of workforce, and between 2020, so the only 40%. Population increased, the total workforce increased, but the involvement in the agriculture is only 40%. So this we can clearly see the labor issues warrant in the mechanization. So what are the main reasons for this? So one is the laborers have higher wage offerings by the government through rural employment scheme. At the same time, industrialization caused so decline in agriculture. Let us say nowadays the small scale industries entered in B class, C class cities. So those are involving agriculture, they can get fixed pay. Like small industries, they can go in the morning up to evening, they will work. So based on that, the laborers is normally depending on that fixed pay for the jobs. So that is one of the major issue. Yeah. Yes, this is agriculture output on tractor sales. This is closely related. So agriculture output comes means especially, yes, the mechanization also will increase because the customers having a huge cash to buy this mechanism, these machineries. So that automatically the mechanization will increase. The mechanization once increase, automatically the crop growth also increase. So let us look on this figure, the chart. It is clearly indicating that where the tractor volumes are high, in the total agriculture area, the power output is higher from the tractors, right? So we can see the bottom line one is 1,000 hectares mentioned here, and the vertical line is the 1,000 tons. Haryana is having the highest, so close to 170 tractors. So that the productivity also you can see here. So more than 3,500 tons per hectare, the productivity. So in Punjab, it is close to 140 tractors per 1,000 hectares. Also productivity is very high. At the same time, it is clearly indicating that if the mechanization increases, productivity also will increase. It is clearly indicating. So apart from the agriculture, tractors are using so in this area and called non-agriculture area. So those are, if you talk about the example, one is the haulage activity to supply the material from one place to another place. At the same time, attaching the dozer, loader. So this type of equipment also economically, so they can use. So like in road construction in B-class, C-class cities. So they're also doing this job with the tractors. So yeah, we'll go to next. Yeah, in this figure, so you can see, so if you're selling the tractors around 100 tractors, so around 70%, close to 70% of the tractors involving agriculture, remaining 20 to 40% of the tractors are engaging in non-agriculture jobs. So that is the one demand area. Once customer buy the tractor, it can use in agriculture area or non-agriculture area based on the seasonal demand based. At the same time, if the tractor availability is there, so they can go for the rental basis so that small holding farmers can get these missionaries in this farm to work. So it is clearly indicating that the impact on the tractorization. So more money, more cash, so that they can buy, purchase, and machines again and again. Once they see the benefit of these machines, yes, definitely. So they will again come and purchase the machineries. The next point. So here you can see the monsoon. So the monsoon drive is very, very important for the tractor industry. So monsoon will good means. So normally the tractor industry numbers also is good. You can see the rainfall, there are two figures. One is the rainfall and tractor sales. So the graph, so not in the same year. So in the next 1 or 2 years, the tractor industry will be good. If this year is the rain monsoon is good. So the next 1 or 2 years, the tractor industry is not always good. Why? So adequate reservoir levels. So this is the one reason. So you can see the graph. It is clearly indicating that the monsoon is good. The graph is also increasing. Yes, the next one is in the monsoon period, the surplus, the rainfall normally results adequate the reservoir level in the reservoir so that it will give the impact on the rabi crops, of course. So at the same time, so you can see here the numbers. The reservoir level is low means automatically the crop total acre percentage also come down. So the benefit is the local government bodies will announce the message normally. So based on the availability of the reservoir level, either they can go for the water crops like paddy or they can or any other crops. So like that. So the reservoir level is low means the percentage of acreage is also low. The reservoir level is good means the percentage is also good. So it is clearly indicating. It means that so the monsoon also is very, very important for the tractor market. The other factor is the major factor is the government policy deployment, right? So what are those can say? This is the credit availability for the farmers and subsidies, issue of credit cards, MSP for crops and crop insurance. So these are the main drivers from the government area. Once government announced this thing, yes, definitely it will impact on the tractor market. Yeah, so the other one is the demand of food grains. So this is our country's vision by 2030. So our vision is produce 355 million tons of grains. So to meet that, yes, the mechanization is very, very important. So you can see the figures here. Yeah, so through to achieve this, the mechanization is very important. So not only for the tractors, the other areas like other machineries, small machineries, because in our country, small holding farmers are high. So we need to craft, we need to modify. So small machineries where small farmers also can adopt these machineries. Can you move next?
Next is about okay. The tractor industry.
Yeah. So let's understand the Indian tractor industry manufacturers availability in our country and figures and stage wise. I would request Mr. Anand to take part. Yes, Anand.
Thanks, Sumesh. So good afternoon, everyone. So let us study some of the dynamics of tractor industry with respect to the HP segment-wise, brand-wise, and other aspect as well. I'm going to show the tractor population in the past 5 years, the tractor market share by the different manufacturers. If you look at here, these are the brand names or manufacturer name where you are seeing on the left hand side of your screen. Here, M&M group means it is tractor brand like M&M and mainly Swaraj. Means these are the two brands contributing to M&M group. So if you group, if you look at these five years, so these are the market share. For example, 2001 market share is 38%. These two brands put together. While it comes to the TAFE group, for your understanding, it is brands like Massey Ferguson and Asia Tractors. So these two brands put together, it is forming around 18 to 20%, whereas in last year it is 18%. Right? And the Sonalika has another tractor manufacturer and the brand name is same. This was the market share in last financial year. And Escorts market share is around 11.3, John Deere 9.5, and these are the other manufacturers. If you look at the inferences of these things, let us say top five manufacturers are contributing 90% of the tractor sales. Out of around 20 manufacturers, top five manufacturers are contributing 90%. And if you take top 20% of manufacturers, that itself will contribute again around 80%, which is following the Pareto rule, where 20% of contributors or the manufacturers contributing 80% of tractor sales. So these are the other tractor brands which you can see. These are the sources of retail finance funding. For the year 2018, one figure is taken for our understanding. It is the TIV in domestic market, it is 7.1 lakh. Out of this, 5.5 lakh tractor, that is around 77% of tractors were funded by private players, which includes private banks and finance companies. And whereas public sector cooperative banks and nationalized banks contributing around 9%, the rest of the volumes around 13% is through their cash purchases. So you can see it very clearly, it's around more than 85% of the tractors are purchased through the finance help, either from a private institution or the PSU banks and or government institutions. If you look at the HP segment wise, see, in tractor, generally the tractors are classified into different ways. It is based on the applications. We can say it's a mini tractor, compact tractor, mid-range tractor. That is one kind of application or one kind of classification. And similarly, based on the HP category, we can classify the tractor into these four categories for Indian market, for our understanding. Let us say less than 30 HP category, 31 to 40 HP, 41 to 50, above 50 HP tractors are put together can be called as one category. So there are four categories of tractors with respect to horsepower. I'm just comparing, I'm taking one decade numbers here. If you look at the financial year 2011, less than 30 HP tractors are around 15%. 30 to 40%, it's around 44%. 41 to 50, it's around 28%, its contribution. And above 50 HP tractors are around 11.9 tractors percentage. If you look at the same financial year 19, this has increased. You can see here the increase in sales of 40 to 50 HP tractor, whereas reduction in the sales of, slight reduction in the sales of 30 to 50. So because the buyer who is going for a next tractor, generally the people are having the tendency of upgrading themselves. So the people who have owned less than 40 HP tractor, they are going for slightly higher horsepower tractor. But still, so this is the highest contributor. If we add these two, 30 to 50 HP, this is contributing around 80% of tractor market. 30 horsepower to 50 horsepower range of tractors are contributing 80% of tractor sales in India. 7.5% is above 50 HP tractor sales. 9.5% is for less than 30 HP of tractors.
Let us understand the people, Anand. So
yeah,
we'll have one poll here.
Yes, so sure.
We can have our next poll.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let us have one more poll. Yeah.
Yes. So the question is, which state is the largest contributor in total tractor sales in the financial year 2020?
Yeah, in the year financial year 2020, which state is the largest contributor in terms of total tractor sales, sale volume?
Yeah, quickly, we will close in next 20 seconds.
Yeah, we'll keep on getting the responses. Very good. Very good, team has started giving the responses. It seems like the Punjab and Uttar Pradesh numbers are the votes which we have received for these two, or a little closer.
Yeah.
13 responses so far. We will give some more seconds, Sumesh, for the participants to respond.
Yeah, okay. So why we have chosen year 2020? So the year highest tractors produced and sold in India.
Yes.
So that's what we have chosen this 2020.
There are 15 responses so far. I request participants to participate in the poll. Yeah, last 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The poll.
So as a result, results is there in your screen. Uttar Pradesh responses were 63%. Let us see the correct answers as well. I'm just moving to the next slide. If you look at, these are the TIV analysis for the year 2020, financial year 20. The state-wise, the volume and as well as their state-wise contribution to the total tractor sale for Pan India is given here. If you look at the state-wise, I'm just taking important inferences for you. Let us say Uttar Pradesh has contributed around 17% of total tractor sale volume. Whereas we have seen the tractor penetration in the previous previous slides, Umesh has shared the tractor penetration is the highest in states like Haryana and Punjab. So the difference is, of course, the tractor penetration per 1,000 hectares are very high compared to other states. Whereas UP, in terms of population, total population tractor sales per year, it is more. And if you look at the zone-wise in the Indian market, it is you can see here, the north zone, which consists UP, Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab. So this is a industry convenience, the zones are created. There is no legal zones like that. So it is an industry convenience. If you add these two, four states put together, contributing around 36% of total tractor sales. If you add other states like West Zone states, MP, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Gujarat is adding another 33. So these two put together nearly 70% of tractor sale is happening in North and West Zone of the country. Whereas South is contributing around 17% and East Zone, which consists of Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, West Bengal and Northeast, contributing around 14% of total tractor sale. Let us see the tractor penetration. So if you, as we, as most of us are aware, the farmers in India can be classified into four types, like marginal, small, medium, and large, based on the land holding which they have. Let us also see the around 82 million of farm households are there in total. Let us see the tractor penetration in each type of farmers. So these are the tractor penetration around the year 2014 and 15. The trend is almost similar even now. So large farmers having a 46% of these large farmers are having a tractor. Whereas medium farmer, around 21% of medium farmers are having tractors. And small and medium marginal farmers put together, if you look at the total volume or percentage, it's more than around 82% of farmers are medium and marginal, whereas they are owning only 1.2% of farmers only owning the tractor. Right? So reasonably, the medium and large farmers penetration is high, whereas a small and marginal farmers, the penetration is comparatively low. There may be other reasons why their penetration is less, that we can see later. And these are the populations. As we have discussed, though the penetration is more, let us say large farmers, the penetration is more, but population share is less, because in terms of volume, they are less than 5%. You can see here, less than 1% of farmers are large farmers. So they are contributing around 9% of tractor population share. Medium size farmers, they are contributing around 72%. Here, the volume is around 82% of farmers are contributing around 90%. So here mainly the scope is there for small and marginal farmers to increase the tractor population. That's what this point is also tapping the same point actually. Huge opportunity in medium and small farmers. It's not only the new tractor, there is a need for tractor actually. The need for mechanization is there, but there are different options are there for them to go for a new tractor, or go for second hand, or subsidies, or custom hiring models can be adopted. This is the farm power availability in different countries. Some countries are taken for our consideration, like USA, 7 kilowatt per hectare, and Japan, 14 kilowatt per hectare, Korea, 7 kilowatt per hectare. Whereas in India, it is 2 kilowatt per hectare. Whereas to achieve our projected food grain targets, we need to have minimum 4 kilowatt per hectare of farm power in total. So power used in farms should be minimum 4 kilowatt to increase the productivity. This figure which you are seeing in the screen is talking about the contribution of different powers in the farm. Let us say I'm taking the latest figure itself. Let us say around 2 kilowatt is the total power in India means. Out of that, the percentage wise, 45% of farm power is derived from tractor source. Electric motor is remaining 26, diesel engine is 16. Rest of the powers like human power, drought, animals, and power tiller is also contributing. So the increase in tractor power and the increase in electric power ultimately will contribute in increasing more power availability in the farms, which will increase the farm mechanization. It will have much more consequences, like better consequences, like more production, productivity, quality of work, quality of production also. So this is what the potential of tractors market. Currently, it's around 5 million. But if you go by this, let us say total agriculture area in million acres, 393. Tractor hours minimum, 20 hours of tractors operation is required in a farm. How many hours of tractor operation is required? This many, 7,855 million of tractor hours are required in the farms in India. Average, a tractor can run up to, average running is 10 hours. Minimum 60 hours, 60 days, we have to operate the tractor in a farm. Average, if you look at this calculation, average one Indian tractor is will run 600 hours per year. So if you calculating by this, we need, even to meet the current need, we need 13 million of tractors to mechanize the farms, all the farms of Pan India. So in addition to that, there are some need for non-agriculture purpose as well. So put together, it's around 16 is the tractor potential. Sorry, just let me start the screen again.
It is a poll also in this.
Yeah.
So Kruti, you can launch the poll.
Let us see one poll now. Let us see
the
poll.
I hope participants can see the poll. It's there on the screen.
Yeah. Yes, thanks. It's visible.
The question is farm
mechanization, percentage in India.
Yeah.
So there is one question. What is the farm mechanization percentage in India? Is it 20, 60, 80? Farm mechanization level. Percentage of farm mechanization in our market. Okay, 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%. There are four options are given. We have started getting the responses.
Yeah, quickly we'll close in 10 seconds.
Yeah, we'll take another 10 seconds to close this poll. Thank you. Thanks for the responses so far. So as per this, very good. So around 53% of participants have told our farm mechanization level in percentages, 40% in India. Let us see the answers as per. Okay, I'm moving ahead with the upcoming slide. So this is, remember one more point here. If average CAGR of, even if it is 8%, it makes another minimum 15 to 20 years to reach this population. So this point is telling about the potential of tractors, tractor market in India. So a lot of, though we are a largest tractor manufacturer and tractor consumer in the world, still there is a lot of potential in tractor market. And these are the different mechanization level in different stages of crop cycles. Let us say in seed bed preparation, including tillage, it's around 40, irrigation 37, plant production 37, seed and planting 29, harvesting and post harvesting is 60 to 70. So this includes a tractor and other machines like electric, diesel engines, petrol engines, all put together, the mechanization level is mentioned. So if you look at the average of this, this will come around, let us say the Indian number, it's around 40% is the mechanization rate, around that. Whereas 55% of population is engaged in agriculture. And agriculture is contributing around 17.4% of India's total GDP. So this varies with country to countries. Like if we compare, China can be compared very easily because in terms of land coverage, land area and the population, we can match this. We are close, slightly mismatching. Whereas if you look at the Europe, especially the Western Europe, GDP contribution of agriculture is high. Only 4% of population is engaged in agriculture and mechanization rate is very high. So there are many reasons, land holding, population of the people, labor availability, these are the main contributor in mechanization. If you look at the tractor penetration, like countries like UK, Italy, it's more than 100, even Japan is 460. India is around, in India, it is 63 unit of tractor per 1000 hectare. So this is the tractor penetration. This was in the case of 2019. This also need to be increased, tractor penetration in total, pan-India level. As we have discussed, tractor penetration in the states like the Punjab and Haryana has reached some good number, whereas in other states, still they have to improve. So as we are aware, but very, very important point, why the tractor penetration is low, and this can be the reason for why the lower HP tractors also serve. Average tractor HP in India is 30 to 50, whereas countries like Europe and US, it's 100 plus is the average tractor HP. The reason is, main reason is, land holding is very less, size of land. As we have discussed, more than 83% of farmers are small and marginal, low cost human, and adequate animal forces also available. And the farm machineries, if you look at the farm machineries in other than the tractor, tractor is contributing in farm mechanization. And there are other machines also which need to be used along with the tractor. Let us say there are around 250 medium and large scale units in India. There are 2,500 small scale industries, 15,000 small tiny industries in farm machinery domain. There are more than 1 million village level artisans, means technicians who are working in implement manufacturing repairs, machinery repairs and maintenance area. Large and medium scale manufacturers includes the tractor manufacturer, power tillers, diesel engine, irrigation pumps, combine and harvester, and other air moving machineries. All these bigger manufacturing companies are contributing in farm machinery manufacturing. So they have the dedicated dealer network, after sales service. They are very structured manufacturers. Out of this, the major sale, the biggest market is happening in the tractors, threshers, and power tillers as of now. There are other small and tiny manufacturers as well who are making the implements at the smaller level. For example, the cultivator, small rotavator manufacturers also there in the market, which includes harrow, cultivator, disc blow, other implements, implement manufacturers. We have discussed there are village craftsmen of that who are maintaining, repairing, and as well as fabricating some of these equipments which will be used in the farm machineries. You can find in the rural places, every village there will be a machinist, welder, or fabricator who are doing, lathe workshop owner who is doing this such jobs. So they're also contributing in farm machinery industry in total. So these are the numbers, market size, annuals, annual market size number and its industry size. So this was for the year 2014, but the proportion is almost similar. Whereas if you look at the total tractor farm machinery, tractor is contributing heavily in terms of industry volume, in the business volume as well. The other implement, all these things, if you are looking at this, all these things put together, these are the implements. Remember one thing, tractor without attachment, without the machinery's implements, it is nothing. It is just a prime mover, which will help the implements to do the job. So without implements, we can't use the tractors. So understanding on implements and focus on the implements are very, very crucial to improve the farm mechanization level of the country. Whereas tractorization has happened up to some extent, but there is a very important need of increasing the farm mechanization through adding these implements, attachments, which can be used in the farm in addition to the tractors. So these are some of the numbers, the manufacturer numbers of different equipments. So if you want to talk about what's new in the tractor industry, okay, let us say electric tractor is in the place. Escort is the first company which introduced electric tractor. 3-4 years back, we have started giving it to the continents like Europe and other markets. Domestic markets also, it is available now. Four-wheel drive tractor is another trend. Though it is not very new technology, the trend is increasing. People have started taking more number of four-wheel drive front axle tractors. Mini tractors like 12 to 20 HP tractors, which can be used for inter-row cultivations like cotton and sugarcane, it is also a new trend. And CRDA engine is a need of the hour, especially to meet TREM 4 norms. TREM 4 norms are expected, tractor emission 4 norms are expected in coming financial year, April onwards, in the Indian market. Especially above 50 HP tractors has to follow this stringent TREM 4 norms. To meet that, manufacturers are going towards common rail diesel injection, direct injection engine, which will help us in meeting the emission norm, and as well as it is having other benefits like fuel efficiency, power, lesser noise and lesser vibration and more comfort to the operator. Turbocharger with intercooler unit is the another technology. This has become, its demand is increasing now. And similarly, more number of gear speeds. Let us say this is one example I have given. Similarly, different manufacturers are giving different speeds. 20 speed gearbox is one such example. We'll have 16 forward and 4 reverse speed. Because tractor can be used more than 100 applications. To meet it, each application will demand different traveling speed from the tractor. So more number of gear selection option will always helpful to get more productivity and as well as with a lesser time. So here are some of the recommendations to increase the farm mechanization level, its tractorization and as well as the farm mechanization level. Which can be, one such can be increasing number of custom hiring center. As we have seen, more than 83% of farmers are marginal and small farmers, which were not economically stronger enough to buy a big machines and equipments. Because to have a farm mechanization, it is a tractor alone will not ensure a tractor farm mechanization. Tractor itself come with a cost. Normal 40 HP tractor in India, it's costing around 6 to 8 lakh. So in addition to that, people have to buy other implements also, from tillage, seedbed preparation to post harvesting. So if they want to buy a tractor with all the implements, mean the implement cost will be equal to tractor and sometimes more than tractor price. So that is one challenge. So custom hiring center is one option, and increasing the credit level for machineries. Agriculture loans are there, but increasing the its farm mechanization contribution, loans for farm machineries, that needs to be increased. And the financial assistance to the farmer in terms of subsidy or lower rate of interest will help them to buy machines. And farmer educations on new technologies, tractor, along with the tractor, other machineries like implement educations are required through live demonstrations to them and proper trainings. So this will help them to operate the machines or confidently buying and using these machines. Still, there is a need of educating the farmers on these technologies. And similarly, and there is a need of developing the customized farm machines as well. Because in Indian conditions, different crops are there in different economic zones, agroeconomic zones. Each crop will demand different solutions. So that needs to be addressed with the proper tools and equipments. So that still there is a need of development of these indigenous technologies for different challenges faced by the farmers. So that area on R&D and equipment, new inventions, still there is a lot of scope. And upskilling the rural manpower, not only the farmers, we discussed about the rural artisans, right? Craftsmans. So we need to upskill them in terms of new machineries, new tractors and allied implements with respect to the operation and maintenance of these machines. So these are some of the steps which will help to increase the farm mechanization and as well as the tractorization level in India. So this is about the subject. We are almost at the end of the session. We are about to wrap up the session, but prior to that, we would like to add a few information about the training, our training center also, which may be helpful to you or your colleagues or your others to share with. So we have a training center at Escorts at Bangalore, our ETDC, Escorts Training and Development Center. So this was established in 1969 to increase the farm or to contribute the farm mechanization level in the country. So far, we have trained more than 2 lakh people, farmers, agriculture engineering students, university faculties, and as well as rural technicians, and as well as tractor sales team. So here, one such glimpses are given. We do the practical trainings to the technicians, field training in our farm. So we have 15 acres of campus and around 75 acres of farm, around 90 acres. So we are using this facility to train the students, farmers, and other community who are involved in agri domain. These are some of the glimpses are given, like how many people we have trained so far. And we have 36 tractor and 85 implements to train the people. We have classrooms, workshops, different workshops, right? Model farm, not only the tractor operation. So tractor operation and as well as the maintenance and as well as the model farm techniques will be taught to the farmers and other people as well. And farmer trainings at our training center is free. It's free of cost. There are different programs are there. 1 day, 3 day, a week program also there. The farmer training is completely free. Whereas for academic team, whether it is the faculties or the students. So we are providing a training by subsidized cost. And it is a residential training center. And people can come and stay and get the training. At one point of time, we have a capacity of around 120 participants can stay and take the trainings. So these are some of the other facilities available in our training center. Especially for the students, we are training every year. We have a summer training in the month of June, 1 month course. that we are doing it for past more than 3 decades. That is continuously we are conducting it. So my submission is, if anybody want to attend the training, or if we want to suggest anybody to attend the training at our placement, you can contact our team, academic team. So this is our mail ID and contact number. You can make a note of this, or if required, you can take a screenshot of the same currently itself to pass it to the relevant or required candidates.
Thank you so much, Mr. Anand and Mr. Umesh, for such an enlightening session. I hope every participant, and we have gained a lot of understanding about the tractor industry. I appreciate having this topic detailed and clarified by such eminent industry experts. I would request, if there are any queries that we might have received in the chat box, we can clarify them.
Thanks, Sukriti. I think we have got some queries, it seems.
Yeah, people are interested in knowing about the impact of pandemic on the tractor industry, but Umesh has already answered that the tractor industry has grown pretty well. So if you can elaborate more on that. And the other question we have is Escorts providing some employment opportunities after the skill training in their center? So we can have that too.
Yeah. So if I, as a training person, my answer will be, we teach you how to catch the fish. So this, that is a, as a training point of view, I can share you. But however, yes, bright candidates from our whoever is attending the training, we always share our recommendation to our HR, so that opportunity also is there. There are some candidates, many candidates who have attended and who are working for a company, our company also. But point is, it's not only about Escorts. So this training which the people are attending at our place, so they will get the confidence in handling the farm machineries and tractor. It's not only at our place. As we discussed, the tractor industry, it's one of the biggest in the world, Indian tractor industry, around 20 plus tractor manufacturers are there. So this will equip you to compete in any level at any place. So that competency improvement is our primary, I can say, we can assure you on that aspect. With respect to the job, that is also possible based on the people's, how they are grasping during the program.
Thank you so much. I hope the answer is clarified and the person has received his answer. Thank you to the audience, because the polls made everything very interesting. The session was very interesting because of the polls, and it involved the active participation of the audience. So I would like to thank all the audience for the active participation. And very big thank you to the industry experts for this enlightening session.
Thank you so much.
Thanks once again for ASEA for giving this wonderful opportunity for us. So all the best to all the participants to succeed in your professional career and as well as in your personal life as well. So wishes from our side. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sukruti. Thank you so much for giving the opportunity in ASEA platform. And purposefully kept the polls because this session was kept in the post-lunch time. Of course, you know that. So that's what, to keep a participant active, we made this plan, right?
No, this happened for the first time in the series of webinar, and it made the webinar very interesting. So we can take this as a learning for the next webinars too. So it was very interesting. Thank you so much. This was new learning for us.
Thank you very much. Thanks to everyone. Thanks for your time.
Thanks to all. Thank you so much. All the best for your pitch. Thank you.